But we are not shocked with what is happening in the country. I think we have told the Zambian people about the character of the PF, the people in government. These people have said time and again, some of them are thieves. They are criminals. You can see what is happening. I'll just give you one example. The recent revelation by the mayor of Lusaka, Mouse Sam. Matafari at City Market pocketed 13 million kwacha. He only remitted 60 million to the council. Nothing happened. Up to date, it's quiet. No one has talked about it. You know, no one is talking about it. Now we have a very senior member from the provincial, of one of the provincial officials from the PF, obtaining money by false pretense. You get tickets and you don't want to pay back to the owners. We have another one, the gold issue. Even the transferring of Commissioner Chushi to go to Western Province, to Northwestern Province, suspicious. Because the people are supposed to go and investigate have been removed from Northwestern, they've been taken to Lusaka. Okay? So I know the issue of gold, it's very, very important for this country. It was going to create jobs, which the president EC Ero promised the Zambian people that I'm going to create jobs. I thought some of the jobs would have come from the gold mines, but it's not coming there. You can see that these people, they are just pocketing our money everywhere. All the scandals which have happened for the past 1 month now, it's all PF. So you Zambian people, can you open your eyes? Can you see what we are seeing as UPND? That these are not the right people to run this country. If you are stealing every coin, everywhere they are stealing. The cadres of PF, they are there because of stealing. The ministers, everyone is just, whatever they touch, there's something wrong. Whatever they are doing, there's something wrong. If there's this kind of stealing everywhere, how do we then trust you with COVID money? You know, this is why we are demanding transparency, accountability. Can you tell us how this money is being used? Of COVID, which is being donated, because we can see that among yourselves there's a lot of misbehaving, there's a lot of thieving. You are stealing too much. Zambian people, open your eyes. We've been telling you these people needs to be shown a door, but thank God we are towards the elections. I only hope this COVID should end now so that we can start going around to campaign and tell the Zambian people what they have already seen. We want to help you, the Zambian people, that the right leadership is the HH leadership. The UPN leadership is the right way to go. You cannot have a government where people are stealing at their own. Every day you wake up, there's this. You wake up, no, people have stolen copper. No, this one. We have the richest boys today because of copper, which is supposed to take revenue to the government, but it's taking into their pockets. This God thing has not started today. The God issue has started from long time, and I can tell you that even some of the DCs in Western Province, senior party officials, they are involved. But I know because government is the senior PF members, the senior ministers are interested in the gold issue. This is why they've sacrificed the cadres, they've fired the cadres and arrested them. We want to see you doing these things everywhere where there's an issue of stealing. Matafari is still working at City Market. Nothing has happened, but 13 million has gone, which is supposed to go and pay the tax, the arrears, the salaries of Lusaka City Council workers. But someone is taking money. These guys are driving expensive cars on our expense. Look at the poverty levels in this country, because the money has gone into their pockets. We want to challenge you, you pranderers. We want to see you now lining up to go and donate over this COVID, because you have a lot of money. You have taken a lot of money from us. We can't sit idle looking at you stealing every day. It's so painful. It's so painful. This is not the Zambia we know. Where every day the cadres are so powerful that they can go to any mine, they can go anywhere and steal at their own will. Nothing is happening. We can't continue like this. Mr. President, what is happening? What is happening? You are a lawyer. What is going on in your country? Can't you see that your ministers are misbehaving? Can't you see that your cadres are misbehaving? Is this the leaders you want to lead for this country? Do you want to be known by the Zambian people as a waste president? Can you do something? It's too much. Enough is enough. This is our country. We have a part. We belong to this country. We are also part and parcel of this country. We cannot continue looking at things going bad. Look what you've done to Prime TV. You want us to forget about Prime TV the way we forgot about the Post. Because a lot of stealing is going to be hidden now, because there's no news, there's no newspaper, there's no media which is going to bring out these issues. If Prime TV was here today, I don't think we'd have known a lot from Northwestern Province what is happening. This has to come to an end. We can't have cadres, ministers, government, you know, sitting on our money. Look at what you're doing in Western Province. On whose interest Do we, can a councillor resign today? 7 months, 8 months from now, there will be elections. Why are you wasting money? You give civil servants in Western Province who are cadres to go and buy councillors 50,000 kwacha so that you can have by election and show to the people that you are now taking over the stronghold of UPND. No, that's not the way you do politics. Take development to Western Province. Do the roads from TBZ to Kaoma there. The road is done. It's finished. From Kazungura to Sesheke, Samungoma there. Do the road. Impress the people of Western Province. Let them resign at their own will. Don't buy them. Don't entice them. We don't have that money. We have a lot of problems in this country. The economy has collapsed. Collapsed, totally collapsed. People are sleeping with hunger. And yet your people are stealing. They are busy laughing. This is why you find that when you talk about PF, cadres will stand up and talk the loudest because they are benefiting. We can't continue, sir. This country does not belong to PF. It belongs to all of us. Enough is enough. Can you put your house in order? This kind of stealing should come to an end. Anyway, Zambian people, this is your chance. At least you have seen for yourself that you cannot have a senior party member stealing God. You cannot have a senior party member obtaining money. You cannot have a cadre stealing 13 million from City Market. You cannot have ministers making deals day in, day out. You can't. You can't run the country like that. I was one of you. I was the first deputy minister to Home Affairs in Michael Sata's time. I don't think these were going to go on like this. Zambian people, wake up now. We are telling you, wake up. Don't say we are behind you. You should not be behind us. We should move together and remove these thieves who are troubling you. Today, this economy, it is what it is today because of the deals which they've been making, deals after deals. So many debts, we don't even know we're going to pay those debts. Maybe our children should be the one to suffer. Now we are suffering.